Good afternoon, students. Okay, I think all of you are doing coding for the assignments regularly. And some of the students are mailing also me if they are facing any problems. So up to now, we have completed all the tree assignments, and from graph, all must have completed BFS, DFS assignment and Dijkstra's assignment also. Then in the last session, we discussed Kruskal's algorithm. Okay. And some of you might have missed Prim's algorithm assignment in the class because attendance was less in the week after T1. So many of you have missed Prim's algorithm assignment. And during the lecture, during the first online meeting, Zoom meeting, we discussed heap sort program also. But the problem given, the ninth assignment given in the syllabus, is related to some real-time problem. So I will be discussing these two assignments in today's session so that you can continue with these two assignments and you can submit the programs in given specified deadline time. Okay. So we will start with the Prim's algorithm assignment. So it is 6 assignment where the real time problem is given. A business house has several offices in different countries. They want to lease phone lines to connect them with each other. And the phone company charges different rent to connect different pairs of cities. Business house want to connect all its offices with a minimum total cost. So one of the MST algorithm we have seen, that is Kruskal's algorithm. And here we are supposed to use Prim's algorithm for implementation of such network. So what is the first task? Represent using appropriate data structure. So we will be using adjacency graph, adjacency matrix representation for storing the graph again, and apply suitable algorithm for finding the total cost. Okay, so here we will be applying Prim's algorithm. Now, what is Prim's algorithm? In this, we don't have to arrange the edges according to the cost given. So that will be the step in the Kruskal's algorithm where we do sorting on the edges. Now here we have to start with any source point. So by default, we will start with source 0. And then we have to continue finding minimum edge. In Prim's algorithm, what happens? There will not be a forest of edges which will be enhancing. There will be a single tree which will be enhancing by adding one by one edge. So in every step, what we do, we find the minimum edge from that vertex. So initially, to start with, we will start with source 0. From source 0, whichever is minimum, we will consider that edge. We will add that edge into MST. And again, from visited edges, we have to visited vertices, we have to select the best possible edge so that the cycle will not be formed. Okay, so we will just revise the example which we have taken during the class. What is the algorithm? It is for building minimum cost spanning tree. At each stage, we have to add least cost edge to tree, such that set of edges is still a tree. So here there will be a connected component which will be enhanced every time. So the output in every stage will be a tree. Okay, and finally we will have all the nodes in that tree and n minus 1 edges. So repeat the edge addition step until t contains n minus 1 edges. So this is the algorithm where initially the T, that is the spanning tree, is initially empty, and visited vertices, we will start with vertex number 0. So visited vertices are vertex number 0 initially. While T contains fewer than n minus 1 edges, that is at the end we will have n minus 1 edges in the graph. So let UV will be list cost age such that U belongs to TV and V does not. So any one of the vertex is visited from the selected age. One vertex will be from the visited and another vertex is not visited. So we have to select such age. Where both the vertices are visited, that means it will form a cycle. If both the vertices are already visited, it will form a cycle. So we will reject such edges. If the cycle is there, we will reject such edges. So if break, if there is no such edge, then break. Otherwise, add V to TV. That means if cycle is not getting formed, then we have to add that edge into TV. TV is visited. That means we will be adding it into spanning tree. Okay, we will be adding that edge into spanning tree, and we will mark it as visited. So all the variables which we are going to take are similar to Dijkstra's algorithm. We have taken visited array, from array, and distance array. So all these three arrays will be same as our Dijkstra's algorithm. So input will be taken in the same way, just the processing will be different here. Okay. So see the example here in this graph. Which, if we start with vertex number 0, then which age will be selected first? For age 10. Okay, 0 to 5, that age will be selected initially. So that is the best decision at this time. Okay, so this age will be selected initially. They will be added into the MST. Next, this age is better. So in the next step, we have these two, out of which this age is better, 25. So that will be added into the MST. In the next case, we have to see all the ages going from vertex number 4, vertex number 0, vertex number 5. So this age is best amongst possible. So we are enhancing the same component, 0 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3. In the next step, this age will be added, 3 to 2, which is 12, that is added. In the next step, age 1 to 6, that is 14, is added. So we have visited all the vertices and n minus 1 edges are there in the component. Okay, so this is Prim's algorithm which we have seen, and we had solved the example also in this way. You must have remembered all these steps. So this is adjacency matrix, which will be first converted into cost matrix. So that is the first step, converting this adjacency matrix into cost matrix by replacing all zeros with infinity. Then you have to initialize these three arrays, distance, visited, and from. In distance array, we will have row from vertex 0. This 0th row as it is into the distance array. So 0, 15. But zeros are replaced with infinity in the cost matrix. So here infinity, 15, infinity, 10, infinity, infinity. And self distance will be 0. So 0 to 0 is 0. So this infinity will be replaced by 0. Okay. Then this vertex number 0 is marked as visited, and in from array we will have all at 0, isn't it? We have solved this example. So this is initialization of our arrays which we are going to use further. And minimum cost is initially 0, minimum distance is initially infinity. So this will be varying every time. This will be minimum distance from this array every time to non-visited vertices. The number of edges, we will start with n minus 1 and then go to 0. because we need n minus 1 edges in MST. Okay. So we'll see the program. I will open the program in Word because many of you did not see the program last time. They were not being able to see the program properly in code blocks. I will execute it in code blocks, but I will show it in Word. So this is the program. So this is same as Dijkstra's algorithm. Class graph, then read graph, print graph are also same as Dijkstra's algorithm. I will not explain this part. Here you have to take adjacency matrix as input. First number of vertices from user, initialize all the elements of matrix at zero. Then take number of edges from user, and for every edge take source, destination and weight and update with the matrix. So this is undirected graph, that's why symmetric matrix will be created. Okay. And in print graph we are displaying all non-zero edges, and here we are accessing only upper triangular or lower triangular matrix because it is symmetric matrix. That's why access upper triangular or lower triangular matrix so that the edges will not be repeated. Then in Prim's algorithm, the initialization of all the variables, first step will be creation of cost matrix from adjacency matrix. So here all the zeros will be replaced by infinity. Infinity is declared as 9999. So all the zeros will be replaced by infinity here. Then that is the first step. Then initialization of all the three arrays, distance of zero will be zero and visited of zero is marked as one. For 1 to n, for other elements in distance and from array, distance will be copied from cost matrix from 0th row. Okay, because 0 is our starting vertex. So 0th row, all the elements will be copied. Then from array, all elements will be 0 in from array. And visited of I is 0 initially, except visited of 0 is 1. So for others, all the vertices are initially not visited. Then, so this is initialization of all the variables which we are going to use. And minimum cost is initially 0 and number of edges required is n minus 1. So we will go from n minus 1 to 0. You can have in incremented way also the loop. So this while loop is nothing but our Prim's algorithm. This while loop is our Prim's algorithm, where first step is to find minimum distance edge to non-visited vertices. The vertices which are yet not visited, from that find the minimum distance edge. So we will access distance array and from that we will search which is minimum edge. So initially we will assume that minimum distance edge is infinity and then go on comparing it with the other. So at the end of this loop we will have vertex V, which is the minimum vertex, and the distance to that vertex will be stored, that is distance of I will be stored in minimum distance variable, and this edge, this distance will be added, minimum distance will be added in our MST. Okay, and this edge, which is V and from of V, from of V is source. Okay, source to destination is V. So this edge UV will be added in the MST. Now what will be the output to store MST? We have taken another object. We have taken another object spanning, name as spanning here, graph object spanning, in which we will be storing the edges selected for adding into the MST. Because every tree is a graph. So the edges can be stored in the graph object. So this edge which we have selected from the distance array, minimum distance edge, UV will be added here in the spanning tree. So spanning dot g of uv is equal to that distance. Here you can write minimum distance also. Okay. And spanning dot g of vu is also distance of v. Minimum cost is equal to previous minimum cost plus the cost selected. So up to this it is similar like Dijkstra's algorithm. Finding the minimum distance age. Okay, but there we were not adding it into the MST or doing some anything like that. Okay, here we need to add that age into the MST, and then number of ages minus minus, because our loop depends on this number of ages. Okay, so the loop counter is modified, and visited of that weave is marked as 1 because it is added into the MST, so it will be marked as 1. So this is done. We have added it into MST. Now what is this loop for? This loop will update the distance array if we are getting better distance age from the currently visited vertex to non-visited vertices. If we are getting better age, then we will be modifying those edges. Okay, so if visited of I is not equal to 0 and the cost of IV, or you can have VI also here, cost of VI, that is from current vertex to that particular vertex, if cost of VI is less than distance of I, then modify the distance array value to cost of VI and modify its predecessor also to V. Okay, so we will modify that distance array and its respective from array also, because from vertex V we have obtained that better distance age, so we will modify it. But to continue with the example, what we did here, we did the same thing, finding minimum distance age. Here 10 was having minimum distance, so this vertex V it will be 3 in this case, and V2 0, that is from of V is this U, so 0, 3 age will be added into the MST. Okay. And it will be vertex number 3 is marked as visitor. Okay, and then we are comparing the elements from this array, the cost, with row number 3, that is this. Here we are doing direct comparison.
Are you okay, Mukesh?
Yes.
Hamra name.
Yes. Any problem?
Open karna ha.
Any problem? Please mute the voice. So here we are directly comparing the values. In Dijkstra's algorithm, we add the cost required to visit that vertex in this row, and then we compare. Here we are doing direct comparison in Prims. That is the difference. In Dijkstra's, this is Dijkstra's algorithm. Here we select the minimum distance age and we add the cost required to visit that vertex plus the cost matrix row elements. Okay, that is added here. But in Prims, direct comparison is done. In Prims, we are directly comparing, and if we are getting better distance age, then we are replacing that age with a new one. Okay. So this is Prims algorithm. So I have executed the same example. You can see this. Okay. So these are the edges selected. The edges selected are 0, 3, 10, 1, 2, 12, etc. in MST. These edges are added in the MST, and total cost of this MST is 45. This is the processing. These are the final arrays generated. So from this, we are getting this as minimum spanning tree. The graph is shown here. Okay. And these are the edges. Okay. So this is Prim's algorithm assignment, which is very similar to Dijkstra's algorithm, but the logic is completely different. Here we want output as minimum spanning tree. In Dijkstra's algorithm, we were interested in shortest path to every vertex. Okay, so we had to maintain the path. Here we want the set of edges as output at the end. Okay, so here from array will tell us. From array will tell us the edges which are part of MST. So 0, 2, 1 is one edge which is having cost 12. 2, 3 is another edge with cost 10, like that. Or you can display the edges in the matrix which we have declared. Okay? In spanning object. In spanning object, we have declared this matrix where we are adding that minimum cost edge. You can display the call display for this also, spanning dot g. Okay, so here spanning dot print graph is called. So both are giving us same thing. Spanning dot print graph will also give the same thing like from array. Okay, from array also you can display the edges. So, is there any problem in Prim's algorithm? Yes? So, this is one assignment which you have to complete in this week. And one more assignment is assignment number 9, which is heap sort. Okay? So, before hash assignment, go for this assignment because recently we have covered the theory related to it. So, what this assignment is saying is, Part A is the internship is offered to students based on rank obtained in second year of graduation. Create suitable nonlinear data structure to identify next topper student for internship. That is, this is nothing but priority queue implementation. And here we have to use the nonlinear data structure. So priority queue can be implemented using heap data structure, which is nonlinear. So here we will be creating min heap. So in this assignment, for example, here we will take rank obtained from students. Along with this, you can take the GR number also. So it can be array of structures where every structure, every student structure will have the GR number and rank obtained. So these are the ranks which I have written. So GR number and rank you can take from user and create min heap for it. So for first part, first job is to create min heap. Okay, this we have seen how to build the heap. Okay, that I have explained you during the lecture. Also, we have discussed, I have shared the video of it, how to create the heap, this max heapify function. So instead of max heap, we want to create now min heap. Okay, instead of max heap, we will be creating min heap because we want the lowest rank student to be accessible with big O of 1. Okay, that is the expectation that internship is offered to students based on rank. So next rank student will be accessed for next available internship. Okay, so here we will be creating min heap. Then delete min operation. So creation of min heap will be the first step. Then delete min operation to identify next topper student for internship. That is delete root you have to do. Okay, how to do delete root? How to do delete root? First step is you have to swap that root with last element in the heap, that is last element in the array. So swap it and again call min heapify for that root, for root. Okay, this approach also I discussed with you during this assignment, which I have explained already to you. Here, first step is to build heap. Here, in this program, we built the max heap, but you have to create min heap for the current assignment. Okay. So, what we will be doing, we will be heapifying all the internal nodes, starting with last internal node to 0, that is root. Okay, so this is first step, creation of heap. Then in second step, you have to write delete min function, where you will be swapping the last node with root and heapifying the root again. Okay, call heapify to for root again. Okay. This is heapify function. This is written for max heapify. You have to write for min heapify for the first part. Okay. So that is priority queue implementation of min using min heap. Okay. So this is your first part of the assignment. And I have shared the PPT also for the same. Building min heap, how to build min heap, etc. Okay. And then performing delete min operation, that is delete min element in the heap, which is root node, and place this element at the end in the sorted array. And then you have to call heapify for the root so that next minimum should appear at the root. Okay, this you have to continue. So this is priority queue implementation using heap. Then part B of this assignment is also extra academic input is to be given to the 10 students with low grades. Okay, so you have to identify the next students with low grades, sort the student data in ascending order of grades. Okay, so here for arranging in ascending order, you need max heap. So that last 10 students of the heap can be identified, or here you can arrange in descending order also, so that first 10 students in the array will be accessed for giving extra inputs. Okay, so here you have to perform sorting on the heap. If you are creating min heap, you can go for arranging in descending order, because using minimum heap, arranging in descending order is done. Okay. So if you have created min heap, you can easily arrange in descending order. But if you are creating max heap, then you have to arrange in the ascending order using max heap. Okay. So for first part, you need min heap only. Okay. And for second part, if you are arranging in ascending order, you need max. Okay, so both the functions must be there in your program, create min heap and create max heap. Okay, and after that heap is created, in the second part you have to do the heap sort. So heap sort, this program we have already discussed, sorting program, where first step is to create heap, create max heap, and second step we are swapping the root with the last element, A of 0 with the last element, and then we are heapifying that root. Okay, and this we are repeating multiple times. Yeah. So in delete root also you have to do the same thing, but there will not be any loop. Okay, in heap sort there is loop, because every element will be occupying root position and going to the last. Okay, that's it. So this will not be there in delete root. So you have to write that delete root function also, where this loop will not be there. Okay. Am I supposed to explain this program again to you, or you will be able to do by yourself? Yes. Any suggestions? You can listen to the video where I explained this code. Yeah, I have already explained this code in the heap sort, and that link is also available on YouTube. So I have shared that link on VOLP as well as Google Classroom. Okay, so listen to that video again. But here, what you need to do is, in second part, first is create min heap, which you have already done in the first part, and sort in descending order of grades, display first 10 students of given for the given inputs. Okay, that is heap sort algorithm. Clear? So in first part, priority queue implementation using minheap, and in the second part, heap sort algorithm using minheap. Okay, so here you will be arranging in descending order. If you have understood that ascending order, then you can go for it also, no problem. But then you have to create max heap queue. Okay, is the assignment clear? What you need to do? So listen to that video. You will get the code also, explanation for heap sort code also, and some modification you need to do for whatever real-time problem we have to solve, okay, using rank. Okay, try this program and try to follow the deadlines given on the Google Classroom for the assignment. Okay, for heap sort, actually on Google Classroom, I have given two parts. One is theoretical assignment and another is program. So wherever I am writing assignment 9, that is at that point I am expecting the write up and program from you. A PDF should be uploaded with write up and program its output. Okay, complete PDF is expected. So some of you are just solving the problem and uploading for heap sort assignment number 9. I am seeing that many students just they are solving the problem and uploading, but it is not expected. Here in assignment 9, practical assignment is expected. Okay.